In 2009, New Jerseyans voted for a new direction. They voted for change. For two decades, before Chris Christie took the oath of office as governor, the state of New Jersey, under Democratic and Republican administrations, had a government that effectively breeded corruption, increased the size and scale of government, increased taxes and spending, and ignored the challenges of a pension system that needed change. New Jerseyans elected Governor Chris Christie and Lieutenant Governor Kim Godano to reform the state of New Jersey, to grow our economy and get our fiscal house in order. And since taking office in January of 2010, Governor Christie and Lieutenant Governor Kim Godano have had a record of positive results and bipartisan accomplishments. On the issue of government spending, that's been one of their strong suits. The governor took office in a time when the state was just months away from seeing every single check it wrote bounce. So the governor went to work and unilaterally cut spending by more than 9%. Today, New Jersey has a surplus for the first time in years. The governor has balanced the budget while holding the line on taxes. Governor Christie has sought tax reform in our state. He started by capping property tax increases in our state by 2.5% and has created tax incentives for businesses to create jobs in the state of New Jersey. As a result, we have 55,000 private sector jobs we did not have when the governor took office in 2010. Governor Christie has worked hard on education reform, expanding school choice to high school students, and passing the first tenure reform law in a century, giving school districts the necessary change they need in requiring accountability for teachers before they could be fully tenured. The governor passed bipartisan pension reform that asks public sector workers to pay a little bit more into their pension and benefits while saving their retirements and their jobs, while saving the taxpayers millions of dollars each year. Be it cutting spending, holding the line on taxes, reforming education, making it better. This state has some of the best schools in America. But this bill improves it. Like anything else in life, education can always be improved. And we ought to improve it in our state. We've also managed to save our pension system, make it more efficient and more cost effective. We have shrunk the size of government since the governor's taken office. He's taken on departments of government in this state which have not worked. With a more effective government, more jobs, and for the first time in a long time, higher taxes not being the answer to all of our problems, sweeping education reform, Governor Chris Christie deserves re-election. That is why I hereby endorse Governor Chris Christie and Lieutenant Governor Kim Godano for a second term. Now, the issues I mentioned, job growth, spending, and education, pensions, taxes, these are all issues where the governor and Lieutenant Governor have made progress. But there's more work to be done. Today, Governor Christie is proposing a 10% across-the-board income tax cut for every single New Jerseyan. I believe that cutting taxes here in New Jersey is crucial. We're the highest tax state in America. I'm glad the governor did not raise taxes, but I think it's now time to reduce taxes. In the 8 years before Chris Christie took office, taxes were raised 115 times. Chris Christie's predecessor, John Corzine, presided over the taking away of a property tax rebate program he promised 4 years before that Governor Christie restored. Our state is going to have to rebuild after the horror of Hurricane Sandy. I'm proud to say that Chris Christie has been a leader in that effort. Another note on Sandy. During the horror of the hurricane, horrible events, lives were disrupted. The one silver lining that I found was I was thankful that Chris Christie was governor of the state of New Jersey. He acted in a way that was decisive and necessary to get us through the horrors of those days, and to too many, they remain a horror on a daily basis right now. Now, Governor Christie offers us a clear choice, a contrast with whoever the Democrats nominate. Fiscally conservative, a a reformer on education and pensions and the tax system here in this state, presiding over job growth in this state. These are all very crucial things. That is what Governor Christie represents. Now, the core-signed Democrats who oppose him have sometimes worked with him, and that is to their credit. But I'm afraid that no matter who the Democrats nominate, be it Barbara Bono, Dick Cody, Frank Pallone, Stephen Swaney, the Democratic nominee for governor will represent the partisan politics of class warfare and envy that dominated our state under John Corzine, and the pessimism and failure to act that dominated our state for two decades before Chris Christie took office. Democrats are holding the Christie tax cut hostage, and they stand in the way of our state getting the tax relief we need. They've also tried to oppose Governor Christie's spending, some of Governor Christie's spending reductions. Luckily, the governor has acted decisively. So we have two very different views here in this state. We have one view that says New Jersey can reduce its spending. We can reform our education to better educate the future generation of Americans. We can change our pension and benefit system. We can create jobs in this state. And the other says we need more government, higher taxes, and more spending. It's a very philosophical differences, but it's a clear difference. And I'm happy to also say that aside from his policy accomplishments and his vision for the future of the state of New Jersey, this governor has led in a way that makes us all proud. He does have a record, as I said, of positive results and bipartisan accomplishments. The governor's been a strong and effective leader. He does not need polls to tell him how to lead, and he leads with integrity and conviction and purpose. He tells people the truth, whether they want to hear it or not. That is a distinct difference from what is happening in politics today. Unfortunately, many of the Corzine Democrats who oppose Governor Christie, in addition to wanting to bring us to the politics of class warfare and envy that have dominated our politics for too long, they want to make Trenton politics much the same as Washington politics, divisive and not based on common sense. It's unfortunate, but it's true. Now is a time for us to work together to continue on the progress that we've made over the past few years under the strong and steady leadership of Governor Chris Christie. We've made progress. We've made a lot of progress. We have accomplishments to look back at, but we have more to look forward to. We've gotten it right on education. We've gotten it right on pensions. We've gotten it right on spending. We're on the right track with taxes. It is now time to do more. We need to cut our tax rates even more to make us more competitive, to bring people back into moving into the state. We need to deal with the illegal immigration problem in this state. We need to make sure that we continue to improve our infrastructure, as Governor Christie has done during his time in office. In fact, organized labor is now beginning to support Governor Christie because of his efforts in infrastructure in this state. We need to get our toll rates under control. Now, these are all things that we have to say yes to. And I'm happy that the governor has said yes to a lot that has benefited our state's economy and working families in the state. The governor's also known what to say no to. The governor said no to complying with Obamacare. The governor said no to regional cap and trade. The governor said no to the politics of class warfare. Corzine Democrats support the politics of raising taxes on the wealthy, which does little to reduce the deficit. Governors opposed Democrats' wasteful spending. In closing, I'd just like to say this. I believe that Governor Christie and the Republicans must work with the Democrats, but they must also challenge them when they are wrong. When we talk about the Democratic Party, we must vigorously oppose them where we believe they are wrong, but be willing to work with them on what we believe is right. That's what this governor has done. That is what Republicans in the state Senate and Assembly in the state of New Jersey have done. I wish that President Obama would extend that same courtesy to Republicans in Congress and Washington, D.C. For the first time in years, instead of Trenton being gridlocked, Trenton is a role model for the rest of the nation. Governor Christie's reforms, especially in pensions, have been a model for the nation. Governors like Scott Walker of Wisconsin, for instance, have followed the governor's example. The governor's truth style, the governor's style of telling the truth has also been something that others have looked to. Paul LePage of Maine was elected governor of the year after Chris Christie. Much like him, he tells the truth no matter what. This governor has a record of positive results, bipartisan leadership. He's a decisive leader, and he deserves our vote and confidence in 2013 when he runs for re-election as governor of the greatest state in the greatest nation that the world has ever seen.
Tomorrow all the things were gone, work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt.